Do you find issue when you wear your bra like this, where the bottom is hanging out? Your boobs feel like it's almost falling out. And when you put on a shirt, your top look like this. Do you find when you wear your shirt and your bra, you find your bra like this, you have double boobs, sometimes triple boobs, where it comes in here, where it seems like you have more than one boobs? Well, I have the answer and I can help you. So stay tuned. Do your boobs get like this when you wear your bra, where it all flickered out and bushed up like that? There is nothing here. So when you put on your top, does it look like that, where you see the boobs showing here? So it's like you have four boobs in one in your shirt. So it looks like this. Yes? All right. I am here to help. Okay? Call me your godmother. Call me your lifesaver, but I'm gonna save the day. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, Simple Life of Jolene. For all you guys that are new, welcome. For all my returning subscriber, welcome. Glad you guys are all here. Today, as you guys can see from my title, we're gonna be talking about bra. Yes, bra. Big boobs, big boobs, girl problem. Yes, you guys all know. If you guys are one of those girls who have big boobs like myself, it might not look like I have big boobs, but I do. I am 34 triple D, and I can go for 34 E and F. So if you're one of those people like me who struggle to find the proper bra and the proper fit, so your sisters can stay snatch and comfortable all day, I am here to help. Make sure you guys subscribe to my channel for fashion video, DIY, beauty, vlog, lifestyle, being a mom, you name it, I am jack of all trade. I pretty much do every and everything on this channel. I try to help my girls out. I will try and help my boys out with stuff too. You know, we're all one community. We're all one family. We're here to share and spread the word. Who out there can relate to me? I remember growing up, I was raised by my dad. So talking about bra and getting sizing and all those stuff was not in my dad dictionary. He was pretty much like, yeah, he was a mommy dad, but he always said to me, you know what, when it comes to a period and your boobs and all those stuff, that's supposed to be done by a woman, not a man. So he pretty much keep it simple and he give me the basic. So I actually want to help though, you know, the young ladies that are coming up, even the older ladies now, because a lot of us are wearing bra and thinking that we are wearing the right bra and not knowing that we're actually wearing the wrong bra. So I am going to talk to you guys about getting fit, getting bra fit the right way. When you go to store, some of the time, I don't know if you guys are like me, I remember going to Lavie & Rose, Victoria's Secret, what's the other one called? La Senza, and pretty much a lot of bra store, and they were always telling me like, oh, you're 34D, and then I'll go, and for some reason I'll buy the bra, I'll try it on, and they're like, oh, that's perfect. And it seemed to me, from me walking from out the store, going into my car, driving home, these boobs seem to have grown two more size up. So when I go home, the bra doesn't fit properly anymore. And I'm sitting there like, but these people tell me I was 34. Like, what's going on? Like, when I sit there, my boobs would be like falling out. So if I go and I have a bra and I have to constantly keep pulling it down because it was there and it was the most uncomfortable part, or even this part for say was keep pulling back, so my boobs were falling out, so I have to keep pulling it like that. How much of you guys can relate to that? You're out in public and your boobs is like protruding out in your shirt because it's going out of your bra and you have to sit there discreetly, you know, hoping nobody see you pulling the bra cover back to the front to cover your sisters so you can go back on with your day. So you spend your whole day keep adjusting your bra, fixing your bra and stuff. You know what, ladies? The honest truth is we're all wearing the wrong bra, and that's the reason. One of the tips I want to give you, first tips, when you guys are going to get your bra like size and you're going to a store, make sure you're not going the day when you're on your period. Like, don't go and get size on your size, like sizing up your boobs when you're on your period, because normally when we're on our period, everything is like swollen. Your stomach is swollen, your boobs is swollen, everywhere is swollen. So when you go now, you're not gonna get the accurate size. So that's gonna be one of your issues to keep in mind. Go when you're not on your period. And the other thing is, if you gone to the store and say, for instance, like for my case, they told me I was 34D. But then when I got a 34D, it wasn't fitting properly because this bra that I actually show you, that I was showing you in the thing, this is actually 34D. Bought the bra, love the bra, and I'm like, oh my God, it's gonna fit. And when it comes, it was giving me like four sisters. I was having like double boobs. And I was like, no, I can't have that. Like, that's the most embarrassing thing when you're wearing shirt. If you see a lot of women out there, they're wearing these nice tops. And when you look at them, their boobs is like pushing up. So you see the boob here and then you see this piece up here that's pushing up. Doesn't look sexy. Doesn't look cute. And the reason for that is you're wearing the wrong bra, sister. So sometimes what's wrong with us is we don't want to go up a size. We just always want to stick to that size because we tell ourselves like, oh my God, I'm 34D. I'm not no 34E. But sometimes we have to realize that you're getting the wrong bra, and if you're getting the same bra, same size that they're recommending to you, and it's not fitting properly, then it's not the right size. So for instance, the second suggestion I'm going to say, if you go to the store and they tell you that you're 34D, and you buy the 34D, you bring it home, and you realize that it's not fitting properly, you're still having the issue. Go back to the store or even look and see if you can go up to 34E, like E. Because sometimes what happens is a lot of store, and this is what I find. When I went to La Vie en Rose, La Senza, and what's the other one called? Let's think of it. Victoria's Secret. A lot of them didn't have 34E. So they keep recommend, oh, get 34DDD. But sometimes I find too, depending on the shape of the bra, it's not fitting properly and I'm having the same issue. So try and go up a next size. And if they don't carry it, and one of the thing when you see from my last video that I actually post, where I show my lingerie, that's why I said I actually love H&M, because I find them to be very open in the sense that they carry a lot of variety of sizes. So I was able to find like 34E, 34F. Like for instance, this bra that I'm wearing that I actually show you guys, this is 34F. So this actually give me full coverage of my bra, of my boobs. So if I wanted a little bit more, where I wanted to show a little bit more, I could have gone with the 34E. But I find that I don't have to keep going to 34DDD. I can actually do E and F. So that's something you guys should keep in mind to try and go up a size if that's the issue, and then see the comfort and see what it convert to. Sometimes they'll look at you and tell you like, okay, if you're 34D, you can go and try 36E. Keep in mind, if your bra around here, like your bra here, your bust is 34 and you go to 36, remember now, this bra strap is going to be loose. So when you put this strap on and you lock it, let me lock it so I can show you. So when you lock it and you put it on under your clothes, you're gonna find you're gonna have this issue where your bra is pulling up like this. And why? It's because it's not the right size around your waist, around your bust. Your bust is 34, so you have to stay in the 34 bust. But try and find a different cup. So the problem is the cup, not the bust. So if you find that, okay, you try the 36 and the bust, like the bra strap fit perfect, okay, then you're a 36. But if you find that when you, because one of the things that a lot of people don't know, for instance, when you get a bra, it has three sections, 1, 2, 3. You're normally supposed to start from the front. So you should never buy a bra where you're actually starting from the back. Because one of the things they said, as the bra get old and you know you wash it in the laundry and you dry it in the dryer, they sometimes shrink. So what they always say is you're supposed to actually start from the outer one to the inner one. So as it gets looser, or it doesn't, like you find it looser at the top, you can always go up. You shouldn't, they said you should never have to go a bra where you're actually going from the back to the front. You should actually go from the front to the back. And that's one of the things a lot of people don't tell you. Yes. Remember, you're wearing these items, like whether it's an underwear, whether it's a bra. Remember, bra is something that we wear 7 days a week, 365 days of the week, of the year, sorry, 365 days of the year. The only time we actually take these things off is maybe when we're going to bed. So what you need to remember is you have to find a bra that is comfortable. And one of the things I find too, if you have big boobs, try to avoid bra that actually comes with a low cut like this. You see, bra like comes with a low cut like this tend to actually make your boob fall out. Try to get a bra that actually like this one, where it actually has more, it comes up more. So this one comes around more in your bra, so it actually fit your boob area better. These ones, I would say, is more for people who has more smaller boobs or stuff. And if you want something like this, like a pattern like this, get one that's a little bit more up, like something that comes up a little bit more, not just like this, because it's not giving you enough coverage. And that's one of the reasons why when you wear the bra, your boobs is actually falling out, or it's giving you double boobs. It's because of how the shape of the bra. So keep that in mind too when you're going shopping. Sometimes if you're looking for your size and you find that you're having trouble, it could be the shape. So look at the shape and say, okay, you know what, I tried this shape, it doesn't work. Then you can look at yourself and say, okay, I'm gonna, oh, this one is the same, so I can't even show the thing. But then you're gonna tell yourself, okay, I'm gonna try one with a little bit more shape here. So you go for something like that. Try to get one. These bra, try to sometime avoid bra like this that gives you a little bit of coverage. Because if you see here, it leaves a lot here. So the problem is it leaves room for your boobs to fall out. So try to find a bra with a more bigger, a cup or a more shape that actually cover your boobs area more. So that's a next thing to keep in mind. And
hey guys, I thought it would be a great idea for me to put in some shapes of bra to give you guys an idea of what shapes are out there. These are just a few different shapes. It's not all the shapes that we do have out there. We have a lot of variety, but I thought I'll just pick out the more popular one that a lot of people wear. And I thought it'd be easier for me to just write the description on the picture so you guys get an idea. Hopefully this helped my ladies. Hopefully this helped when you guys are going shopping. Let's get right back in the video.
As I said before, don't be afraid to size up. I know sometimes we want to have that sexy bra, and trust me, I'm the same. Like, I'll go out and I'll look and I'm like, oh my god, I don't want no granny bra, I don't want no old looking bra. But sometimes you have to remember, sometimes we have to realize that Yeah, the bra might not be as sexy as you want, but it could be very comfortably in the sense that it's giving you comfort. And the other thing that I find too, I don't know if you're the same, I can't stand sometimes the wire. I find the wire hurts underneath my boobs. So what I try to even go for now is a non-wire, like one of them that doesn't have wire, like the wireless bra. I find it gives more comfort, and I find that it actually, when you sit, you don't have any
Yeah,
pain. So
because
make sure you look for bra that actually give you comfort that is all day. So I was able to grab one of the bra so I can show you that what I was gonna say. So this bra actually is a wireless bra. You see it in my last haul, and this one has no wire under it. It has like a, just if you can see there, yeah. So it's just like sewed, but it has that foam cup. So this one is like a foam bra. But if you look on this one, this is sexy. But at the same time, exactly what I'm trying to say. You see it here come cut higher. So because it cut higher, it holds your sister in more. And will give it more security, but at the same time, this will be more comfortable. So if you wear this all day, you have more comfort and you have less pain, like sometimes with the wire, where the wire sit underneath your collarbone or your ribs, and it hurts after a while. So this one actually won't give you any hurt. So some of the time, what you have to do is, if you find that you go to a certain store and you're not finding your size, try a different store. Don't buy a size that is not yours. So when you put on your clothes now, you look like you have triple girls. Have you ever find where you've been wearing the wrong bra and you finally get fit the proper way and you find that bra that actually fits your sisters and you actually put on your clothes and you wear it all day? Do you ever even realize how much of a difference it make when you're out there and you have on that bra and you realize that you don't have to make any adjustment throughout the day? Maybe yeah, the strap might fall and you fix the strap, other than that. But if you look at it, it's like so much comfort. Like the boobs feels different, everything feel different. And one other thing too I want to share, because for girls who are big breasted, and I find that too with myself, I find that we sweat a lot underneath her bra because we have a lot of sisters, so they're sitting there, so you sweat. So one of the thing I can say that you guys can use, if that you find that you sweat a lot under your breast, put some baby powder. Like when you have a shower, you can put some baby powder. Like you can put the non-scented one if you want, and just put it under your boobs. That will help you to actually give you comfort all day. You can even use like even cornstarch. That's even a good one too, because you know what. You maybe have cornstarch in your kitchen. You can put some under there too. That will keep your boobs like moist and actually prevent it from like sweating a lot and water running. You don't want that and stuff. So that's one of the thing. And the other thing too that you guys might not realize, and too, be careful when you're washing your bra in the washing machine, because if you're gonna wash your bra in the washing machine, make sure you put it in either a socks or even in a bra bag and throw it in. Because if you throw it in by itself, when it goes in there and it's washing with other stuff, the wire will actually get tangled, and I find that the wire will start protruding out, and that will stick you, and that will make the most uncomfortable thing too. And it also damage your bra very quick. So keep that in mind when you are washing your bra, to put it into something that protects it, so it lasts longer. I'm gonna say that's pretty much it. I'm gonna make this video short and sweet. So remember, tip one, never go and get size on your period. Your boobs swole. Make sure when you're going to the store that you get the proper size. So if you go to the store and they tell you that it's 34 and you find like, okay, you're 36 triple D, and you find the triple D is not fitting, ask them for a different bra shape to see if it's the shape of the bra that's causing the issue, why it's not fitting the way you want. Also, hop for like a wireless bra and see. Go for a foam bra. Sometimes I find with the foam bra it gives more comfort and it fits more better. So those are the three ideas I'll keep. Those are the three ideas I will give you girls to try when you're going to get your bra done. I know a lot of time our parents don't tell us this, or we don't seem to talk about bra when it comes to girls and parents. And this is one of the things that we need to teach our young girls, and we need to even educate ourselves too, because we never get educated. So always remember to try different bra if it doesn't fit. If you find that bra don't fit at that store, go to a different store. If you find like, okay, you're triple D and triple D doesn't fit, ask for a next size up from triple D. Ask them what size do they carry other from triple D. What other size come next? If you're a 36E and it doesn't fit, ask them for a 36F and see if that's the cup. It can make a difference. Try different stores and see. Some always keep in mind that some shape take away some of the cup because of how they shape the bra. So that's why they always say there's always a shape and size for everyone. But remember, pick your size, and you will avoid all these issues. You will avoid the embarrassment. You avoid the have to be going out adjusting your bra, trying to be discreet. You will avoid the self-consciousness. Like, it will help you to be more conscious when you go out and more confident in yourself when you have a bra that fits you proper. Remember, bra and underwear is something we wear all the time. So that is something where you get your confidence first before you put on a outfit. So always make sure that that department is fully taken care of, fit right, fit tight before you step out of your house. I hope this video helps someone. And if you guys like, don't forget to share, don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you on the other one. Stay sexy. Bye.